Just look at the damage left behind when a drunk driver slams right into a local home. The kitchen destroyed. A tarp used to keep out the rain and snow. And it gets worse.
Are you going to try and tough this out?
I'm sorry. I am. I don't know what to do. I can't get no help from that.
This breaks your heart. Investigator Jim Parsons live in the newsroom with a story you'll see only on 4. Jim.
Yeah, Sally, for the past 40 years, Odessa Wilson has lived a quiet life in the same house in the Hill District, but her peace and quiet were shattered early Sunday morning by a drunk driver, and now she has no way to make the repairs necessary to allow her to keep her independence.
I'll be all right.
The only comfort 82-year-old Odessa Wilson could find today was from her neighbor, Bill Foster. She's heartsick over what lies beneath this gigantic blue tarp at the back of her house. Come inside Odessa's kitchen with me.
Wow.
And you can see why she is despondent.
That's where the car came through.
Mm-hmm.
What were you thinking when you saw this?
Broken heart.
It all happened about 2 o'clock Sunday morning. A car came around this bend here, slammed into the back of that parked gray Cadillac, almost hit this pole as it ricocheted this way right into Mrs. Wilson's kitchen. Pittsburgh police charged the 23-year-old female driver with DUI, and also her car only had the minimum liability insurance, $5,000. The estimate to make repairs to this house, $13,000.
That little bit they're giving me, that ain't gonna help. Nobody would come in here and do that to help to do that work. That's what got me upset.
And to make matters even worse, so Odessa canceled her homeowner's insurance in August in order to pay her utilities.
I mean, it's a hell of a predicament. I mean, this is a senior citizen, you know. She's on a fixed income. And for a freak accident to happen like that, it's just unreal, you know.
Foster has called the city and local charities to try to get his neighbor help. But for now, this elderly widow on the hill is alone with her troubles.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to do. I can't get no help from that.
Well, we certainly couldn't leave Mrs. Wilson in a state like that without trying to help. I called Allegheny County's Area Agency on the Aging this afternoon. I told them Mrs. Wilson's story. They promised to send a caseworker out to her house tonight to see what they can do to help. We'll let you know how she makes out. In the newsroom, Jim Parsons, Channel 4 Action News.
Oh, thank you so much, Jim.